And joining us now is the former ABS-CBN News Europe Bureau Chief Danny Buenafea for more on the life and legacy of the Queen Elizabeth II. Danny, thanks for joining us today and welcome to the program. Glad to have you on board.
Yeah, good afternoon, Carmina. It's good to have you also. After a long time, I always watch you. It's just like on the spot without Tony Velasquez.
I wish he could be here with me, but he's in DZMM right now doing his own noontime newscast. But yeah, Danny, so let's talk about this. Let's talk about the passing of Queen Elizabeth II, the end of the second Elizabethan age. How big of an impact do you think will this have on Great Britain as you know it, being the news bureau chief there for quite some time? And of course, the rest of the world, Danny.
Yeah, it was quite an impact, Carmina. Actually, I've been covering London during my foreign posting for 13 years in London. Mm-hmm. I had a rare opportunity to cover yung dalawang yung royal weddings in 2011. That was Prince William. Tapos the second one, 2018, 7 years apart, Windsor Palace. Mm-hmm. Prince Harry naman. Mm-hmm. So together with Rosie Clarinal, who is now the current news bureau head of Europe. In 2011, I distinctly remember, Carmina, that was the only time, I'm trying to recall, that I think that was the only time I had a glimpse of the Queen. Mm-hmm. Probably it's just about 150 yards away because the wedding was at Westminster Abbey, mm-hmm. Cathedral.
Yes.
Oh, and there was a media platform in front of us kasi napaka-strict no nung pag-cover noon. Mm-hmm. So we were quite afar no from the wedding reception, but we can see them, all of the dignitaries there, all the big guests no. And during the wedding from the Buckingham Palace, they had the royal carriage, yung nakasakay sila sa kabayo, no? Mm-hmm. And then for that, I had the rare chance also to interview me and Rose. Mm-hmm. Interviewed si Lily Pixio. Mm-hmm. If you remember, she was the nanny, yung the Filipino
yes.
nanny who yeah, na nag-alaga yan both for William and
Harry,
no? Mm-hmm. But she was a member of the household staff of Lady Diana for almost 12 years. Mm-hmm. So she practically was the one who,
who raised the boys.
Harry mm-hmm. and William, mm-hmm. they grew up with nanny, with this nanny. Kaya she was the only one invited. That when we interviewed Lily Pixio, I remember she was crying. Dahil nga sabi niya, sobrang overjoyed daw siya dahil not everyone was invited to that reception.
Mm-hmm. At parang anak din niya yung ikinasalin, di ba?
Yes, yes. Oh. So she was a nurse before she was hired by Lady Diana, pagpakulod. And hindi ko na alam kung ano nang nangyari sa kanya. But, you know, when I was still in London, Carmina, mm-hmm. I used to see her in the tube. Alam mo yung tube, yung parang
yes.
underground train nila. Uh-huh. Nakikita ko pa siya. Ganun lang siya ka-normal uh-huh. na tao. No? So,
pero Danny, how would you explain that here we are mourning the passing of the longest reigning monarch ever, no? She was a monarch, yet she was also widely seen to be the mother of Great Britain. Bakit ganun na lang yung relasyon niya dito sa mga tao? Go ahead.
I remember, but there were also turbulent times, diba, during
correct.
The time of Lady Diana, na mm-hmm. medyo, siyempre, favorite si Lady Diana at the time, and then naging sour yung relationship. Pero I was not yet part of that coverage team, no? Pero I remember from people talking, no, talagang na-preserve niya eh, yung dignity ng royal family, no. And ang laking bagay kasi somehow yung respect for her eh, dahil during the yung mga pagpapalit ng mga leaders like the UK, kita mo si Distrust pa yung huli, no. At least nakita niya pa yung remaining moments ni Queen Elizabeth, no. Mm-hmm. At kasi, di ba, ang daming pagpapalit sa UK during the time pa kanila John Major, whoever mm-hmm. then. O, kaya, nakita ko yung ano. Tapos yung huli, because I was covering yung Filipino concerns, di ba? Yung, mm-hmm. yung huli, si May Parsons, I think Rose was the one who covered the first Filipina naman na nag-administer ng
COVID vaccine.
Yung COVID vaccine that was in 2020, mm-hmm. siya bigyan siya ng George Cross Award. Ito yung yeah. parang isa sa mga pinakamalaki na binibigay na award for those na nag-excel no sa mm-hmm. humanitarian services. So that ang in-administer niya pa yung Pfizer na sa 90-year-old na si Margaret Kinner. Mm-hmm. So binigyan siya at ang nagbigay ng award noon is si Prince Philip at that time.
Correct.
2020 pero ito kinonfer lang itong 2022 na. That mm-hmm. was one of the official mga moments na in-administer ni Queen Elizabeth before ito nangyari na nga, na tragic at least almost 96 years old
and more than 70 years no in her reign as a sovereign. Oh, a final question, Danny, no. Even before she ascended to the throne, during her first speech, no, there was a point there when she said her life, whether it be long or short, will be dedicated to the crown or to the people, in so many words. Her unwavering commitment to the crown, what kind of example do you think she has set for the future monarchs of Great Britain?
Yeah, it's a tough act to follow, at least for King Philip now. No?
For King Charles, you mean?
King Charles pala, King Charles who is now, that they take over. Mm-mm. So, medyo kasi iba yung respect that I've seen for Queen Elizabeth II, even for Filipinos there. Alam mo kasi, highly regarded din kasi ang mga Filipinos dyan, lalo na dun sa medical sector. Mm-mm. At saka siya, very respectful siya sa mga Filipinos, no? Si Queen Elizabeth, talagang she visits yung lahat, yung Royal Brompton, lahat tong kung saan nag-serve. Kasi alam mo, Carmina, 8% of the mga foreign doon sa medical sector are from abroad.
Correct.
Mostly Indians and Filipinos.
Yes.
They are highly regarded. So, you know nga, si May Parsons nga from Pasay, siya nga isa nakakuha ng Golden Cross Award. So, ang laki din ng respect din ng mga Filipino. Kaya nga, pag napunta ka lang sa even pag merong konting event lang sa I think the second time na I was able to get a glimpse pero hindi medyo malayo rin during the London Olympics in 2012
mm-hmm.
kasi nandoon naman sila sa Buckingham sa balcony section
mm-hmm.
pero again there was a media platform na napakalayo na we could not get very much closer to the area
mm-hmm.
so hindi mo talaga siya makikita pero yung lang ma-feel mo na nakikita mo siya and then from a distance talagang kikilabutan ka.
Kaya naman talaga marami ang nalulungkot.
Diba yung presence niya? May magical presence
yes.
niya, Carmina.
Yeah. Yeah. Kaya nga marami ang nalulungkot siya dyan ngayon. Kasama yeah, na rin ang ating Filipino community.
We know it's going to, it's going to happen. Pero yun nga, kaya kita mo ang CNN. I was already glued to CNN since last night nga eh. Kasi I was thinking na sa Balmoral Palace nga, dyan sa Scotland.
Mm-hmm.
Alam ko talagang medyo matindi na yung istorya kasi mm-hmm. although hindi na sinasabing critical pero pumunta na doon si Charles, di ba? Lumipad na from London, dumiretso na sa Scotland.
Okay, Sir Danny, I'm sorry but we're going to have to cut our discussion because we've run out of time but we really do appreciate you joining us today sa ating konting pagbabalik tanaw. Maraming salamat po. Danny Buenafe
thank you,
our former ABS-CBN News Europe